interesting first band. So yeah. Dyrus played a lot of Karthus, but not to great success at PAX.
He had the successful games occasionally, but that's not something I actually expect TSM to do much more of. Dyrus has always been a player who has a small champion pool of highly practiced champions. So at least with a couple of these bans, what Gaming Gear is doing is they're just banning pretty much what TSM played at regionals and not much deeper than that.
So we do see Elise also being taken away. Orianna and Sona. This is a big deal because so many teams I've talked to, Lemon Dogs just a few moments ago, say, you banned Sona away, Inspiro's in trouble.
Yeah, well, Inspiro played Sona 6 times. He went 5-1 with it in the International Wildcard Tournament. Outside of that, he played Zyra, went 1-0, but like, come on, he's played everything on Sona. So that's TSM having the smart bans right there. Mazarin's most successful champion is Orianna. Inspiro's most important champion was Sona. So, I mean, TSM is doing exactly what we thought they would, watching the games of the International Wildcard Tournament and basically just banning out the most successful champions for Gaming Gear because they can't necessarily know what they're picking past that.
Well, Twisted Fate was also taken away as Evelynn, but first lock in there was Jarvan. So, Alinir, well, we believe it's going to be Alinir in the jungle with Jarvan.
Yeah, that's most likely just an aggressive jungler he can counter jungle with and go for big early ganks with. And I want to see here what TSM does because I know they've been learning new champions. They have, like, there's no way they have not been. They did not have the most successful picks here. Corki is Wild Turtle's pick.
Well, as is Zed for Reginald, or we believe it will be Reginald at least, he's got a good record on it.
Yeah, people give Reginald a lot of flack for a Zed play.
Well, that video didn't
help.
Sometimes
he makes a couple mistakes, but he's 4-1 on Zed. He has an 80% win rate. And Wild Turtle, I want to talk about his Corki pick for a little bit because he played Corki as his main AD carry back before he was kind of a professional player. Mm-hmm. Also, Corki has a lot of spell-based spill abilities, the ultimate, the Q, all the missiles. And Wild Turtle did play mid lane in Season 2 as well, so this is a transitionary champion for him where he can use his mid skills as well as his AD carry skills. And with the Trinity Force, expecting a lot of early picks and bans this entire tournament for Corki.
We're seeing familiar champions coming out from Gaming Gear here. We have got Gragas locked in that mid lane, as well as Thresh, but quick picks coming from TSM as well. Vi and Fiddlesticks locked in.
Yeah, I didn't want to give too much away there, but the Vi and the Corki are the things that TSM has been practicing. The Odd One has picked Vi as his kind of Elise substitute for these games. The ability for Vi to channel in and guarantee a kill at level 6 is perfect for the TSM playstyle with Reginald in mid lane.
Well, I don't believe Teemo's going to come out here. Sivir is currently being hovered over. We haven't seen what AD and top laner they're going to come out with. Mordekaiser, nope, not really falling for that one. They kept doing that throughout the Gaming Gear when Pain Gaming were there, but they didn't fall for it either.
That's the twist.
But let's talk about Gragas in that mid lane for Mazarin, because that was one of his big champions.
Yeah, and they like to say that Gragas isn't even one of his mains and that they don't care if it gets banned away. But let's be honest, when they qualified back into the International Wildcard Tournament and then even in the International Wildcard Tournament, Mazarin wanted to play Gragas.
Yes.
So that is his tried and true. I think Deadly Brother is going to go. I thought he was going to go for Twitch because that's what he played the most of in the International Wildcard, but he might be a little too vulnerable against Corki. Just can't trade with that damage, so he's going for something a little more mobile.
So we do see NBS locking in that Renekton just like he did at the International Wildcard, as well as Ezreal for Deadly Brother.
Yeah, that Renekton pick, it will be interesting. And I even throughout the entire World Championships here, because Renekton seems to be a favorite pick of a lot of the teams that aren't favored to do very well right now. And I think the success of Renekton and those teams will kind of tell us a lot about the value of those picks.
I'm going to see whether it works out. The final pick, well, it's definitely been deliberated over. Will it be Dyrus's top laner? He's going to be up against Renekton, or it could be in a 2v1 lane, of course.
Shen is available here, and TSM generally just loves picking Shen for Dyrus. That's been their fallback. He also played a lot of Vladimir that got banned away in the finals for them against Cloud9. I'd say it's one of those two picks, but they're taking their time with this one.
Well, it looks like it will be Shen. The crystal ball is still with you, Jat. Don't worry. It's called research, really.
Had to shine it during this because we had the research down for these picks. We know that TSM's composition has been highly practiced. They're mainly looking surprised to work around Reginald right now, but this composition allows them to do that even better because Vi's ganks at level 6 for Reginald can potentially guarantee a kill on a fairly highly mobile Mazarin Gragas. I look at Gaming Gear's team, and aside from the Ezreal pick, that's pretty much exactly what they were playing at the International Wildcard Tournament. NBS is going to look to try and dominate his lane. That doesn't usually work that well against Dyrus because he's such a consistent player, and I think the focus of this game is really Normally it's the mid lane. I'm expecting to see Wild Turtle go crazy against Deadly Brother here, and if something pulls ahead for TSM, it's going to be that late matchup.
Yeah, I do feel that there's a lot of pressure on Mazarin's shoulders here for Gaming Gear. Alinir started things off. We'll see how those ganks work out, but a Zed is very hard to gank in that mid lane early on.
Yeah, the Zed is very mobile for Reginald, and the Gragas play, we know Mazarin doesn't make big plays in mid lane. Gaming Gear in general doesn't actually have extremely strong laning phases. They're the team that likes to group up.
So while the players load into the Rift, let's take a look at who you guys at home think is going to win this first game of the Season 3 World Championships. According to LollySports.com, well, no surprise here. 83% of you think that TSM is going to win their first game at Worlds.
Yeah, all four analysts chose them as well. Freak, although, did have Gaming Gear as his Dark Horse team. Remember, you got to vote with your head, not with your hearts for these games. And sometimes that's a problem for the TSM fans, but the 83% seems valid right now, knowing what huge underdogs Gaming Gear are coming into this tournament.
Well, we'll see how that works out as we start to load into the game. You can see our awesome studios right here. We are on a giant screen. I mean, how good is that? Got to be happy with that ourselves. But the teams are ready, the match is ready, and we, ladies and gentlemen, are about to go into the first game of the Season 3 World Championships. It's going to be Gaming Gear EU as the blue team and Team Solo mid. Well, you can hear the fan favorite as the red team.
Home field advantage here for TSM. A lot of these guys that are going to be playing in this World Championship, some of them haven't been on a plane before. Some of them haven't traveled to the United States before. And that does give TSM a little bit of that edge early on. I think this team composition fits TSM and their play style very strongly. They have the double ninjas already, obviously, with Zed and Shen. It's going to allow Odd One to take some blue buffs as well and not fall behind in farm, knowing that Alunir is an aggressive counter jungler. These matchups, even though Gaming Gear has a team composition that kind of works to the style they played at the International Wildcard Tournament, just seems to favor TSM.
Certainly nothing going to be happening at level one. Haven't even really gone too deep on the ward placement either. If you look around, they normally get that red buff ward placed in there, but neither team has risked just taking those couple of steps into the enemy jungle. So it does mean that the first couple of minutes of this game will be slow, but TSM are gathering for something here.
Yeah, as far as international competition goes, though, Dyrus in particular has had very bad luck against Thresh. If you remember at the All-Star game, he got picked off at level one and died trying to scout. He blamed Doublelift for not checking the bush, but it's still something that TSM is very conservative about, knowing that they are the favorites in this game, knowing that the first game of the World Championships is so important for their momentum. They're playing it a little extra conservative, I'd have to say.
Yeah, it does mean, of course, it's going to be a 2v1 in Spyro down that bottom lane. Reginald just taking a peek, keeping them in focus. And it is going to be a TSM starting off the blue buff. Gaming Gear are going to be doing just the same, but Mazarin's actually in that mid lane. He's already pushing it, keeping that wave cleared. And we can see Inspiro getting caught on Reginald, taking a lot of damage from Deadly Brother already.
Yeah, he actually popped his red elixir right away because he was almost overcommitting so the Odd One could get a good start right here. You can see Mazarin's already just pushed the wave to the turret as quickly as possible. And that's going to put Reggie in a little bit of a small hole here early on in that mid lane.
Oh, some laughing coming out from Mazarin. Seemed very happy with his start there. Of course, gives him that CS lead, the fact that Reggie has only just returned to that lane. Smite was also used by the Odd One. Well, Alinir hasn't used his, but he's just going to be going down that red. That's going to mean red will be a little bit slower for the Odd One in that jungle start.
Yeah, no early counter jungling coming down. Also, the lane swap, which I wonder how that's going to impact here. X Special in the top lane with Wild Turtle will be a strong 2v1 lane. The amount of damage that Corki can burst out onto MBS is quite substantial. I don't think they're going to be able to line up any type of tower dives, and it's going to be a little bit until Wild Turtle can really take off in this game. Both the Trinity Force user AD carries have actually been picked in this game as well, which is something I wanted to talk about. The 311 patch here, Trinity Force now being cheaper, having the remade Phage, and also having 200% damage when you get those Trinity Force procs, really just buffs up Corki and Ezreal to some unreal proportions, and we'll see how they battle against each other in this game. I think Wild Turtle with the Corki should have an edge.
Well, death sentence coming out there. Getting very close to landing. MBS doing a fairly decent job in that top lane at keeping Wild Turtle and X-Special at bay, but this mid lane, this is what we really want to focus on. Reginald versus Mazarin. We feel both teams actually teeter on the edge of how well these players do.
And Reginald's already burned through all of his health pots. Reginald actually put himself in that hole when he tried to help out the Odd One because Deadly Brother and Inspiro were invading the TSM blue buff. So he's actually just in a bit of turtle mode right here. Mazrin's going to continue to push him up to the turret, and unless the odd one comes to help, Reggie's going to be in trouble.
Well, Alunir slid through, tried to be sneaky, but he stood on top of that ward, so he's double buffed up. Is he not really going to get the help from the odd one? So they wisely just step away from this one, realized he'd already been spotted, and makes himself visible. So how do we rate these two? MBS on Renekton versus Dyrus and Shen, because eventually these two are the big tanks of the game. They're going to be the guys getting in the faces of the opposition.
Yeah, and generally the way NBS played in the International Wildcard Tournament was he would be in his own world and try to turn himself into a bit of a lane monster, which is why I like TSM's chances here of trying to keep NBS in a 2v1 most of the time, because Dyrus has spent so much time in 1v2s due to the meta in the LCS for a really long time that he's extremely comfortable and knows he can get his farm back later. Dyrus is also beating NBS just in the early farm. Oddone's been babysitting him a little bit more. And especially if we get into the late game scaling once they are able to farm a little bit, I like his chances on Shen over NBS's chances on Renekton.
So back in his mid lane, neither team going back yet. 5 minutes gone. Mazrin keeping the pressure on towards Reginald, keeping him pushed up against that tower. It does look like Alunir is going to try and take advantage of this, come around, steal those raids. So they saw the odd one was down that bottom. They know this is going to be a free steal.
And this is actually safe counter jungling. This isn't even the aggressive stuff, because he's just using the knowledge that the odd one effectively gave him, and this is actually a little bit of reactive jungling from the odd one, which is something he needs to get away from. He needs to be more of a proactive jungler, because he's essentially getting told where to go right now. Reginald is low in lane, so he's pulling him towards the mid lane. You could tell Gaming Gear was actually already on top of that. That's why Alunir was able to go around, counter jungle yet another camp, and then odd one still has to stay in the mid lane. This is giving Alunir a little bit of an edge on him and lets Gaming Gear actually dictate the pace a bit to TSM.
Yeah, potential for a gank on Dyrus, but both backing away, so realizing it's not on the cards, they are going to go back and buy. Let's see what they come out with. Ruby Crystal going to be for MBS, so he's going for that hell stacking. Armor came out for Dyrus, he went back and got that standard cloth, but the mid lane, because he, Reggie, trying to get that Brutalizer out early, but Mazarin, he's gone for that double Doran's Rings as well as an armor.
Yeah, he doesn't want to get level 6 spiked out by Reginald. He knows what the Vi-Z combo is designed to do. Gaming Gear has done their homework on TSM. So Mazarin's getting a little bit of extra health while making sure he can still clear waves with the spells. But the Cloth Armor is specifically to just guard against the level 6 double Assault and Battery to Deathmark combo that Zed and Vi are going to be trying to execute on him.
Speaking of junglers, Alunir is taking a look down this bottom lane, and this is a potential for a gank. There is a ward in the bush in the river, though. That's going to give them possible to spot it, and they're already backing off.
And TSM is actually going to be putting a bit more emphasis on pink ward control this game. Something I personally noticed when I was scouting a lot of the Korean teams is they pink warded a lot more than the rest of the world. Specifically, they'd get a lot of pink wards on their mid laner and jungler. But here, TSM's kind of taken it a step farther. Oddone's already placed a pink ward. Reggie's got a pink, and even Dyrus does. Knowing that Dyrus has swapped off to the top lane, and knowing that TSM has so many pink wards, they're going to look to pink ward control around the Dragon Pit and then threaten with the stand united from Shen to try to pull off a play. Gaming Gear kind of needs to see this coming if they don't want to concede a dragon.
An interesting, that's an early second back from Wild Turtle. I went back to make sure he got that Phage out, so he's making sure he's safe in that bottom lane. Very secure play from TSM early on, and they know really the ganking potential that Gaming Gear have. This time, Alunir is snuck in towards that bush, but again, look at that. They ping straight on top of him. They know his exact location.
This could still be a little bit tricky, though. They get his bro.
The Inspiro's in all sorts of trouble. This could be first blood going to Team Solo Mid. It will. It's the odd one that picks up first blood.
And check this out by TSM. Alunir was in the Wraith camp because they recognized people were level 6, and they were trying to predictively read TSM here and say, Reggie's going to be here with the odd one. Let's make sure Jarvan's there for the counter gank. But the odd one proactively went to the bottom lane, made his own decision. TSM did not try to camp Reginald's lane, and it gets him the kill, most likely this dragon as well. But Mazarin's actually going down to contest.
Yeah, Alunir going for that red buff steal. We're going to see the flash. He tried to go for the kill. Deadly Brother comes around the side. Dragon is yet to go down. Mazarin's going to get engaged on. He will pop off him towards him. He's going to go down. He can't slide on through. That's going to be another kill. Wild Turtle picks it up.
NBS roamed all the way down. Dyrus has his Shen off.
Dominus comes in there. It's Reginald. They're going to focus on Alunir. Manson to lock him down, but it's Wild Turtle they need to go for because Corki is doing damage. Reginald turns it back around. NBS in all sorts of trouble. He's trying to back away from this one. Has to slide away. Puts Deadly Brother in trouble. And Gaming Gear back away, and it's yet another kill. Alimir going down.
That quick succession of moves gives TSM a 3-kill advantage, and they were honestly just one step ahead of Gaming Gear right there. They knew NBS was coming down. They knew they wanted to wait to bait him into a fight. Let's actually just check out, as he came in, immediately, Dyrus comes in on Shen, as well as X Special setting the trap with the Fiddlesticks ultimate. He got off a full channel in front of all of Gaming Gear, and the worst thing about this fight for Gaming Gear is Wild Turtle's secret weapon, Corki, that he wanted to talk about before this tournament. It's not too secret to anyone else at this point, but 2 kills for him. When he gets that Triforce, he is just going to take off in power and the double buffs. We know how powerful Wild Turtle is going to be in this game.
Yeah, well, that Sheen already completed, so he's well on his way to that Triforce being completed. And as analysts will confirm, it does do tons of damage when in a big fight. So
I agree with that.
Mazarin in that mid lane. We talked about the pressure on him. It is absolutely loaded on him right now. This bottom lane, though, we talked about it at the wildcard tournament. Inspiro and Deadly Brother. We always focused it the weak point for Gaming Gear.
We might get to that in a second because this is a gank coming in from the auto. He has all.
Assault and battery used on towards Mazarin. He's not going to be able to slide away from this one. Puts a lot of damage back on Reginald. Realizes it and does slide away. Nicely done, Mazarin.
The sinking of the ultimates there wasn't quite there for TSM because Reggie's death mark wasn't up. But let's get back to this bottom lane with Deadly Brother and Inspiro because they struggled at the International Wildcard Tournament, specifically in the laning phase. Wild Turtle, especially in the spring split, was just all-star level as far as his play, and he's fallen behind a little bit since then. I feel like just him being on Corki is a mismatch in that lane. Wild Turtle and X Special have more experienced and honestly just more skilled right now than what Deadly Brother and Inspiro can do, because Gaming Gear has yet to show great things in that bottom lane.
The hook lands on towards X Special, but it's being turned back around. Trisha Bros comes across, Inspiro in all sorts of trouble. Wild Turtle puts the damage down, puts the exhaust down. Deadly Brother pursuing him. He's going to chase on through on towards Wild Turtle. Has he got enough damage? Yes, he has. Alunir now slides in there, and you can see Mazarin one more shot towards X Special, flashes away at the right moment to avoid another kill, but it was a one-for-one trade, AD carry for support.
And now it's all about whether Gaming Gear can get a push on this bottom lane. Reggie's pushing mid lane while Gaming Gear has three in the bottom. Overall, that trade isn't that great for either team unless a turret happens.
Unless a turret does happen, he's going to be the odd one just off the side. I don't think he's got enough power to prevent this one, so it's going to be Gaming Gear taking down the first tower of the game against Team Solo Mid.
And that moves the gold as well to about 700. So Gaming Gear fighting back, even though they didn't necessarily get the kills early. That was actually the first reactive play that Gaming Gear had. They recognized that Wild Turtle next special would get a little bit aggressive, and they knew how confident Turtle would be after getting the kills at Dragon Pit and sitting on the double buffs. Great bait there, knowing that Alunir was going to come in from the back with Jarvan. Does pick up Deadly Brother, that very key kill on Ezreal, so he can try and keep pace with Wild Turtle's Trinity Force.
And keeping pace and keeping the heads in the game, because you've got to realize the massive gulf of experience between Team SoloMid and Gaming Gear. TSM, as we mentioned at the start, this is their third time in the World Championships. Looks like the Dragon will be theirs. Gaming Gear not going to be able to contest this one. Alunir thinking of sliding in. True Shot doesn't manage to get it. It will be TSM that take it.
X Special played some really strong defense there from Alunir, who was trying to come in from the side and get the steal. And then the True Shot Barrage actually got the Dragon low enough that the Odd One could just securely smite it away. Big objective control there for TSM, actually. That's going to really help them as they try to outscale here.
MBS not having a successful trade with Dyrus in that top lane now. That didn't seem to go his way at all. So Dyrus getting that power, and he got that Sunfire Cape built up. Mazarin's going to come through. Blue buff will be secured for him, while the Odd One will be taking the blue buff for himself.
They know there's two energy users here for TSM in the mid lane. I'm actually expecting that's probably the last blue buff that the Odd One gets. Wild Turtle requests blue buff when he's playing Corki, because actually the internal cooldown of the missiles, which is normally a second, is affected by cooldown reduction. So if you have a blue buff on Corki, you can shoot out much faster missiles in teamfights, and that's what TSM's going to be looking to do later on in this game, especially now that Wild Turtle has rushed that Trinity Force. Now, he's actually gotten that Trinity Force so much sooner than Deadly Brother because he skipped Vamp Scepter. So he saved that 800 gold as well as the 3 kills he was able to pick up. The power mismatch in this bottom lane is massive right here today.
There is the Trinity Force completed. Wild Turtle returning to lane with that one, so we'll see how that transfers. Deadly Brother, meanwhile, as the Ward battle, would you believe it, starts.
We're not getting into that again.
We're not going to go down that route, ladies and gentlemen. That was Season 2. This is Season 3. Double buff picked up by the Odd One. Alinir was sniffing around to see if he could get in there, and actually may have put himself into an interesting position to get a gank onto Reggie in that mid lane.
Yeah, Odd One is kind of close. There are all ultimates up here. Reginald blowing some cooldowns really quickly here. The ward control is on the other side for Reginald right now, so it's interesting he's not cheating that side of the river a bit more. Now he is.
That seemed like a big bait to me, that one.
Yeah.
Going using that living shadow, getting it towards that middle, saying, come on, slide in,
like,
see
I know
if you
want
to go for me. Meanwhile, Deadly Brother, he's trying to get that Triforce built up as well, it seems. Not going to go for the standard blue build. That was kind of an old build. It doesn't really happen so much anymore. We've seen a lot of Bloodthirster at Ezreal's as well coming out lately in Europe. As it is at the moment, he is some way behind Wild Turtle. In terms of gold, I feel that just between these two is really where the big difference is. You can see it's a 2,000 gold differential for the teams, but in terms of players, well, that 600 gold is making a big difference right now.
That was a great juke by Odd One in mid. And yeah, to talk about the gold a bit more, it's actually Wild Turtle and Dyrus who are the ones stepping up right now. Mazarin and Reggie are really just farming back at each other, and it's the rest of TSMs who's making the moves here for them as they try to move in ahead in this game.
There's the Odd One going. Just going to take out those golems. Well. Red buff going for Alinir. Just using his smite as well, so that's not going to be available the next time around. As it stands, though, TSM, they are 4-1 up. Mm-hmm. And looking confident, so from Gaming Gear's perspective, this is really one of the games, if you look at the other teams, they have to be winning if they want to get themselves out of this group stage. Because TSM, they're going to see as, I hate to say, the weakest target in the group, because these are really, really big groups.
This is the World Championship.
Yeah.
So every team deserves to be here, and every team is going to be a tough game. But with what you said, that is the truth here. Like, both these teams need to win this game as far as predicting their chances of actually making top two in each other's groups. And I really wonder what Gaming Gear is going to do in this one. They excel in team fights, and when TSM is successful, it's actually through a lot of control. And right now, Gaming Gear isn't forcing TSM into any decisions. TSM has all the time in the world to make whatever decisions they want, and they've generally been the right ones in the first 16 minutes of this one.
Alinir, once again, going around to those raids.
They might just try to dive this.
We are seeing Odd One coming in. He's going to flash Assault and Battery up towards Deadly Brother, followed up by the Crowstorm. Inspiro goes down, and now Deadly Brother being locked up. Has to flash away from this one. He is going to get away successfully. The Odd One will not be able to catch him out of there unless he comes back in towards it. Meanwhile, look at Reginald. He's tracking down it. It's a 4v2. Mazarin joins the party. Didn't want to lose two towers, but definitely going to lose that one. That's the first tower for TSM.
And it's that bottom lane mismatch right now that TSM has created over Gaming Gear. It's just the item differential on the AD carries. Yes, they had the jungler there for the turret dive, but those items are not even close. Gaming Gear trying to get something back, 2v1ing the top.
They're going to get this tower as well. Dyrus can't fend them off, so MBS Alinir doing a good job at counteracting that. They realize they're in trouble down the bottom and quickly counter it to get themselves another tower. Keeping that tower advantage, by the way, 2-1 currently to Gaming Gear, so keeping that pressure on. You see the Dragon Timer in the corner, just 1 minute time before that comes around. So let's see what they do. Let's have a look at the items that are starting to gather out, Jack, because we can see a very early Zhonya's Hourglass coming out for Gragas here on Mazarin. Uh-huh. Meanwhile, Reginald, he's trying to get that Blade of the Rune King.
Mazarin is absolutely itemizing to prevent assassination from Reginald, but that also hurts Gragas substantially in trying to put a bunch of damage down in teamfights. Knowing that the next battle is going to be around the Dragon Pit and the mid lane, you want Gragas's AoE damage to hit for full, because that's the main threat in those fights. The fact that he's went for a more defensive Gragas build, I feel like, hurts Gaming Gear as a whole. It's not like that Zhonya's makes Reginald's targets impossible to find. He could just go for Deadly Brother instead and blow him up and get rid of the Trinity Force Ezreal early on in the fight. Pink Ward control, once again, is paramount. Dyrus' ultimate is up on Shen. Gaming Gear is going to try and get this dragon, but I really expect TSM to try a collapse if Gaming Gear tries anything funny.
Odd One having to use his smite there. That's an important one. Dragon is up in 11 seconds, and there's going to be no smite available if Gaming Gear can go for it early. They saw him using it.
And there's a lot of wards in TSM's jungle right now. They do not actually have the pink ward control to stop this, which means Gaming Gear will have choice of where and when to fight. Gaming Gear is forcing on the dragon, and TSM expect them to fight this. They know they have Dyrus, and they know they're stronger.
Crowstorm not available either, so Xspecial's not going to go for that one. There is the Dragon going down, but Inspiro's already been dropped. MBS taking low now down the side. That's going to be a deadly Hunt Brother going down as well. The duo lane, all sorts of trouble. They're flashing away. Alan here trying to get away from Reggie, but I feel Reggie's got the damage to close him down. Tries to catch on towards him. MBS is being taken low as well. Mazarin having to dash through. Alan here, I believe, may have just about got away from this one. It's going to be a 2-0, but Dragon wins with Gaming Gear.
An incredibly risky call for Gaming Gear. They give up 2 kills for the Dragon, which gold values alone is an even trade. But now the man advantage that TSM has in the other lanes is going to turn the tides for TSM.
Well, the middle turret in all sorts of trouble. Mazarin having to back away from that one. TSM will be taking this one down, equaling things up. 2-2 in turrets. But look at Reggie down that bottom. He wants to keep on pushing as well. TSM keeping that advantage, keeping that gold pushing. It's a 3K difference now. We'll see what that equates to in items. The blue buff being stolen away as well from Gaming Gear's jungle.
Yeah, and they gave it to Wild Turtle. He's also got 5 kills up here. Reginald doesn't have energy to escape right now.
Well, Mazarin may be able to lock him down here. He's going to have his ultimate available shortly. Does manage to catch the slowdown. Deadly Brother comes in. He will get the kill. And that is Gaming Gear. MBS in his top lane. He's in trouble, though. Has to slice through and avoids the damage from the Odd One.
Reginald definitely overpushed there in the bottom lane. The rest of TSM was nowhere near for his defense, and Deadly Brother just simply respawned and ran him down. But while Gaming Gear was taking the bottom lane, TSM takes the top, and we could actually see 3-2, depending on how well blue buff Wild Turtle can defend this one as he rolls around the back of the Wraith camp.
He's going to have to do some work here because that tower is going down fast, but look at TSM, they're coming down the river, they're going to try and block them out here. Gaming Gear realizes this, they're going to have to try and back out because the Odd One is closing the gap as well as Dyrus. Wild Turtle goes aggressive, Inspiro might get caught out again. That's a very good barrel coming out from Inspiro.
You can see
Inspiro, he's going to be able to get away, turns the death sentence on towards the Odd One. Odd One just assault and battle and says, thank you very much, I'll go in for this one. But he's going to get away. The exhaust goes down. Mazarin in trouble up the side. He gets feared up. And now you can see TSM turning this back around. MBS has to get away. True Shot Barrage whiffs a pass. Doesn't find his target. And well, that's another kill for TSM.
Even though the Odd One failed his vault over the Wraith Wall, he was still able to get a catch onto Inspiro and get that fight started. And I was talking to Wild Turtle about this Corki pick, and he was talking about how useful he feels when he plays Corki, because all he has to do is sit in the back of fights, throw his missiles, and get in an auto attack or two. And he was saying, you know, I don't even get a lot of kills when I play Corki. I just do a bunch of damage. He's got a lot of kills on Corki right now, and he is a monstrous threat. He's going to be finishing that BF surrounding him. He actually loves going Triforce to Infinity Edge on Corki. He doesn't care about the Vamsect because he's actually so far back. In so many of these fights, the lifesteal isn't a big factor for him.
Yeah, 21 minutes in, the last thing you want to see is 6 kills on your AD carry. Let's not forget Xspecial, because he's on 107 on Fiddlesticks right now, doing a fantastic job at supporting him. So it's all about that bottom lane. We call it as a potential weakness, and Deadly Brother and Inspiro really up against it so far. It's Inspiro that's been caught out most of the time, actually, because Deadly Brother not doing too bad a job. This top lane, these two big tanky champions of NBS on Renekton for Gaming Gear and Dyrus for TSM, of course, on Shen. Well, they're doing a fantastic job, but Dyrus is starting to steal a march in the farming stakes.
Yeah, and we knew this would happen come 22 minutes into the game. Dyrus on Shen knows how to create his own action in the top lane. He will always join with that Shen ultimate, and the game is slow-paced enough right now for TSM that Dyrus gets to be off on his own world. It means NBS has to come and stop him, and it means that TSM automatically creates themselves man advantages elsewhere on the map. Right now, NBS cannot threaten Dyrus realistically in lane, and the rest of TSM is just looking for kills, specifically the Odd One with those Vault Breakers. Sure, he's only 1-0-1, but a lot of the action has been created just by him going in around and trying to make fights.
Reginald trying to bait Mazarin into going aggressive on him. Odd One waiting in the side there in that jungle. Meanwhile, the duo laners, they're holding off that mid lane, and the two top laners, well, they're just going back at it once again in that top lane. NBS is keeping up with Dyrus, but Dyrus, every time he wanders off, they need to be careful. Assault and battery on towards Mazarin. He's going to get locked in. That's going to be the ultimate coming out from Reggie. Uses that Zonyas. Will it be enough? Yes, he will counteract it, and he will survive.
Well, that is the defensive item build coming in from Mazarin, but the question is, what does that really grant him at the end of the day? The rest of NBS, or GG, actually has to use Renekton ult just to get Shen out of there, and there's Xspecial. Special.
Krostov comes in. It's going to be a double kill, and it's X Special that picks them both up, and now they're in trouble. X Special, standing 90, comes out. Dyrus is going to join the party. Exhaust used onto his deadly brother. X Special still just about getting away from this one. Standing 90 was actually cancelled. We'll check that out in a moment. Deadly brother gets taken down. Alinier all on his own on the tower. He's going to get dropped. There's no way out of it here, and it's going to be another double kill for Wild Turtle. 8-1-2 now on the AD carry.
Four kills in the bottom lane, and the Odd One and Reggie just turned that as Wild Turtle arrived. They're going to look to push on an inhibitor turret after that huge teamfight win.
Big, big advantage being gained from Team Solo Mid here. They're going to have to hit and run because the spawn times are still pretty short. We're only 24 minutes into this game. Dyrus doing a fantastic job in the top lane. You can see MBS's hit points already very low. MBS did manage to get the stun on him to prevent it. The ultimate comes out for Mazarine. Not going to be enough. Effectively pushes TSM away.
TSM got everything they wanted with that last set of exchanges. Let's check out this team fight. X Special flashing in afterwards to make sure the fear landed on Mazarin. Both people are dead before they can react, and this was the turn that was so key for TSM. Obviously, Dyrus' ultimate got interrupted by Renekton in the top lane. So, as the Odd One is charging his Vaultbreaker, he runs back only to jump forward. It catches Deadly Brother off guard as Wild Turtle arrived, and Turtle flashes into the turret with turret aggro already on top of him because he was so confident in being able to pick up yet another kill.
Well, we talked about Team Solo Mid stepping it up when the World Championships comes around, and this time in the group stage, they weren't in the group stage, remember, in Season 2. They were the number one seed, got that bye straight in towards, well, Azubu Frost, who you all know finished second in the Worlds last year. Can TSM, though, in the group stage this time around, start getting themselves some experience? Going into cold into that quarterfinal sometimes can be a disadvantage. Remember, this is a double round robin. These teams will be playing
a lot of games
before they get through to that quarterfinal. That could actually be a big advantage going into those quarterfinals.
It's going to mean the teams that come out of this group stage are at least really attuned to the gameplay environment here. They're going to have played 8 games apiece by the time they get there, and TSM is really looking strong to start off 1-0, which for them is a huge improvement win-wise over last year's World Championships. The confidence that they might gain from this, knowing that they're such a momentum-based team, could be absolutely huge. I mean, Wild Turtle alone, who has slumped so heavily from the first split to the second split, he died a lot in this last split. In the finals against Cloud9, he was getting picked on. He had some atrocious games against Cloud9, but now that he's safe and on Corki for him right now, he is just destroying gaming gear almost by himself here.
You can see Inspire is going to get locked on. Reginald comes in. Wild Turtle finishes him off. NBS now having to slice and dice away, but they are just getting picked off at will. Alunir, well, he slides away, tries to get away from that one. But TSM now, they're going to turn for Baron.
And they don't even really care right now. They don't have pink ward control in this area. They just know that if gaming gear comes at them, they're going to go back. X Special hasn't spent the time to clean this area for wards. TSM is going to look to turn and fight. The Odd One still has ultimate. Dyrus still has the taunt flash combo if he needs it. Look out, gaming gear.
You can see MBS is going to get caught out. Assault and battery on towards Mazarin. That's the target they really wanted. Alinir just off of the side. He's trying to get towards Reginald, but simply does not have the damage. Alinir has to get away from this one. But look at this. Actually did good damage on towards Reginald. Dyrus using that stand United. The barrel comes out. MBS holding out very well. But Crowstorm once again comes out from X Special. He gets himself another kill. Wild Turtle comes in, continues his godlike spree. He's now 10-1-3 on the AD carry. Gaming Gear have to pop away. But you can see the flash taunt on towards Deadly Brother. He's going to get focused down. Wild Turtle does go down. Sonya's Auguts from Mazarine. He's going to have to pull something special. The moment he comes out, he does get away. But while this is all happening, Reggie is taking down the top lane.
They were just getting all the objectives right there in the fight against Gaming Gear. That gives them a 9,000 gold advantage. They are now up 6 turrets to 2. And that whole ploy was never to do Baron. It was just to get Gaming Gear far enough away from their base so TSM would have a large area to chase through. They did. Yes, Wild Turtle went down, but that is a big win for TSM.
And while that was all happening, they say it effectively was a 4v5 for a while. Reggie realized, I'm low on hit points, can't get in this fight. You know what? I'm going to go take an objective in that top lane. And it worked out very well for them. 16-4, the kill rate. That's equated to a 9,000 gold advantage for Team Solo Mid. The effectively home turf favorites, I guess you could say. Cloud9, you could argue, are definitely up there as well. But TSM, they've always been one of the big fan favorites here in North America. Third place in Season 1. Quarterfinals place in Season 2. Can they go one better here in Season 3? A lot of pressure on them, and they're already starting their Baron.
This is still a great start. I feel like this Baron is pretty much theirs. Watch Reginald play defense against five people right now. He actually goes in trying to get a kill.
He's going to get a kill on his Spyro. The pop will come through. He will go down. That's going to equate to a support in the mid lane of going down. Baron almost finished off. There it is. Baron taken. TSM, will they turn it around? They're going to go in. Wild Turtle feeling aggressive. I'm not too sure this is the right choice, but they're thinking, what the hell? We've got Baron with full hit points. Let's
go. There's
the
Reverie. He might look for something. They know it's a 4v5. Let's take it easy here, TSM. You guys do not need to go crazy. You picked up a 28-minute Baron buff. TSM has a huge edge right now, and if they can catch the right fight, they're absolutely going to go for it, knowing that Wild Turtle is just massive on items right now. He has a 12,500 gold, which is nearly 3,000 more than Deadly Brother does, his opponent, AD carry. We knew that matchup was going to be rough for gaming gear, but this is a little much.
Well, more importantly, they got three members over 10,000 now as well, so gold being spread across the board as we expected. Look at that gulf in that top lane as well. MBS 2,500 gold behind on Renekton. He can't go in effectively. Dyrus is just a big brick wall as the Randy and the Omen just get completed, so he is a full-on tank hitting you in the face. He may even go for the Triforce, you know. Now he's got that Phage on there. I think, why not? He might well get some damage. Deadly Brother desperately trying to keep this open inhibitor safe, but TSM, they're starting to position themselves nicely. The ward control coming out from X-Special, laying out coverage across that bottom half of the jungle.
Yeah, he's got that Oracle's ticking away still. Well, Turtle getting another last hit there. He actually hasn't needed to out-farm Deadly Brother because he's just killed so many champions. He barely now gets more minion kills than Deadly Brother. They're going in the empty, exposed inhibitor here for Gaming Gear with four people having Baron. They can't dive as deep onto Gaming Gear, so they have to be a little careful in the way they take this inhibitor, but they are so strong that Gaming Gear can't actually engage a fight on them and expect to win.
Yeah, it is going to be a simple inhibitor taken now, and Gaming Gear realize it. They can't get too close. We haven't actually mentioned the fact that X-Special is now 4-1-11 because he's been picking up those kills. Picked up a double kill in there. Doing a fantastic job on support right now alongside him. That bottom lane has been very, very strong for Team Solo Mid. Of course, they went through that change period during the spring. Wild Turtle replacing Chaox. And it has seemingly worked out so far so well for Team SM.
And they're looking to end this game sooner rather than later. When TSM plays well, it's because they play fast and they win games once they have an edge. And boy, do they have an edge right now. Wild Turtle's trying to push up the side lanes. So was Reginald. I expect a five-man group soon. This is the only non-inhibitor turret that is alive for Gaming Gear still in that mid lane. And if TSM doesn't dive it, I'd be fairly surprised. Or it'd be because Wild Turtle's getting a free turret over on the other side.
Dyrus goes in. Quite happily face tanks it in there, takes all the damage from Gaming Gear, but there's just simply nothing they can do. He is a brick wall.
Yeah.
And he takes down that turret with ease.
Not taking any damage. Rand wins and a Sunfire Cape because Mazarin is just strictly not a big enough threat to warrant Dyrus's building of the Spirit Visage. He does not care right now about anything that Gaming Gear has to throw at him.
So the top lane is where the next target will be. It seems that Reggie's going to head off that way. And TSM, well, they could just take any advantage. Looks like they're going to go for that split push. And this is interesting because you think of what they're going to be up against. You think of what Monty said on the analysis desk. They need to be a strong split pushing team against OMG. Maybe, just maybe, they're starting to show, actually, we can be as well.
Reginald has tried to trend more towards split pushing as the summer split progressed. It did not work great for TSM, but they're getting a little bit more practice doing it. Yes, they are against Gaming Gear right now, who is the big underdog of the group, but we don't know the actual strength of these teams relative to one another until we play the games.
Exactly. You've got to remember the SKT1 coming up next. They've never actually played outside of Korea. We'll see how that works out for them, but TSM are the ones in the charge right now as they put the pressure on towards this middle turret. They could go in. Remember, Dyrus just quite happily tanked it out a moment ago. Why not? They're trying to bait out, see if Gaming Gear go in. Reginald trying to peek in. You see him just down on the bottom of your screen there, trying to get a peek off the side there. This turret going down. Dyrus is just tanking that turret.
Yeah, Reginald is looking to flank around the side. TSM has lost their Baron buff, but I don't think they care. Reginald's in the base. The next wave would be long enough for TSM to take down this turret, and if Gaming Gear tries to defend, we're going to see a fight.
We're going to see that fight happen. There's going to be the hook, but it's Dyrus that they caught. Not really the focus target they wanted. Just shadow dashes away. And Reginald, he's keeping those super minions pushing onto the Nexus. Nobody from Gaming Gear is dealing with it yet.
Surprisingly, catching Dyrus, even though you don't usually want to hook a tank, was pretty much the only thing that was stopping TSM from going in on that one, because Dyrus was a little bit too low and a little bit too slow to catch the right initiation that he wants. But this is just danger time for gaming gear. The 11,000 gold leader trying their best to clear the ways. There's the odd one.
Odd one goes in. Vaultbreaker on towards Deadly Brother. Has to get away from that. X-Special comes in with the Crowstorm. The hit points of gaming gear just dropping right down now. MBS is getting on towards the X-Special. Is the only one going low, but the barrel doesn't even do that. That's going to be Deadly Brother going down. Reginald gets himself a second there. Now you can see a Luna flashing away. He's not going to get away from it. It's going to be the turret. That's the second inhibitor turret of the game for TSM. They may be able to turn this into an inhibitor. Full control for TSM.
Once they have two inhibitors down, this game is pretty much well and done. It gives the best access to inhibitor number three. And that wasn't even the cleanest fight for TSM coming in. Wild Turtle got focused, bashed away from fights frequently, and Reginald was actually the one to pick up his second and third kills of the game on Zed. For all the flack Reginald gets for his sometimes substandard Zed play, this will move him, if they win, to 5-1 overall on Zed.
Pressure play from Wild Turtle, but quickly gets away straight away in towards the Dragon Pit. Secures that Dragon for TSM. 19-15, 5 in kills. Third Dragon of the game for Team Solo Mid. They have full control. The Baron will be up in a minute's time. Let's check out that fight.
Absolutely. You can just see how close TSM was to just wiping the floor with gaming gear. X-Special got off a brilliant Fiddlesticks Crowstorm like he has this entire game. But Wild Turtle was pushed back frequently. Only he had turret aggro. Then Mazarin knocked him back. And it was really Reginald who did the majority of the killing for TSM in that fight. Everyone from TSM then had to pull back onto the inhibitor because Gaming Gear was so close to their base, they kept going back and healing up.
X-Special just throwing a little party of his own for Alunir there in the blue buff. Just keeping him away and making sure he gets those wards in. Alunir wanted to get that ward in towards the dragon but wasn't even able to get close to it. And that does mean that TSM, they've actually no reason really to go for Baron other than they have full control. But the fact is, Super Minions are pushing in on towards Gaming Gear. They could just push down this front door.
It really depends on how patient TSM wants to be right now, because they did the last turret dive without the Baron buff and it worked out fine for them. They're actually even stronger now. And if they just wait for Gaming Gear to send a defender to that bottom inhibitor, they would have a window for that. But they're just going to decide to do this with the Baron buff D-Man.
Yeah, 1 second. There it is. Baron is up. And TSM are going to pick this one up for free. Gaming Gear can do absolutely nothing about this one. They are stuck within their own bases and in desperate, desperate trouble in their first game of the World Championships. Team Solo Mid starting out strong here. Trisha Barrage actually was fairly timely there, but it was a little too late.
I really want to see how the stage affects a lot of these teams coming in, because it's something we haven't talked that much about. Like TSM, even though they haven't had the best success on the world stage, knows what it's like to play in North America in front of a crowd, and they didn't have to travel very far for this event. Whereas a team like Gaming Gear, yes, they had the big tournament at Gamescom in Germany, but this is a whole new world for them, and they need to be able to step up for the challenge if they want to win a game in groups.
And let's be clear, TSM know that the crowd is always going to be behind them in America. That is going to be the third inhibitor of the game going down. Bottom one has respawned, but that's not going to stand there much longer. Look at Dyrus. Deadly Brother is putting all the auto attacks on him, and just nothing happening right there. He's got over 4,000 hit points. Shadow Dash lands across. Inspiration is just going to get dropped down by Wild Turtle. That's going to be Assault and Battery on towards Deadly Brother. Reginald just locking up and taking down. Wild Turtle picks another one down. Mazarini gets focused. Can't even use the Zonji's Outcast in time. That is going to be surely the ace. Oh, onto the fountain. Wild Turtle tries to get on there, but Deadly Brother survives. It doesn't matter. It's Team Solo Mid that are going to take the first game of the Season 3 World Championship.
They're going for the next skill, too. They got him.
They got him, ladies and gentlemen. They got him. There he is, Dyrus the Brick Wall in that top lane. Another fantastic game against them. We talked about how big a player he can be for Team Solo Mid, but it was all about that bottom lane pairing. Wild Turtle, yep, and X-Special absolutely going huge in that game.
12 kills for Wild Turtle, 4 kills for X-Special to go along with his 16 assists on that support Fiddlesticks. And TSM knows this is a long World Championship for them. They have 8 games to play in this Group A of the World Championships. It's a great start for TSM, but this by no means is a sign of relief. It just means for TSM the start of their path towards a World Championship.
Yeah, of course, Gaming Gear and TSM will be playing each other again. That will be later on in the week, because remember, we are having 10 games today, 5 tomorrow, 5 the next day, then a break, then another 15, 20 games to go. It's going to be some crazy, crazy week of League of Legends action here. But TSM, they are the first victors of the World Championships, and well,
starting off how it didn't really work out for them in Season 2. They didn't pick up a game in Season 2, so they're already doing better.
Yeah, it's absolutely going to be a marathon for them, though. The one win is nice. It gives them a great start. I don't expect to see Wild Turtle getting Corki that much in the future.
No, I think they've actually maybe lost those cards already and possibly shed away from Dyrus already as well.
Yeah, exactly, because the bans in that game, especially based on TSM's performance, they showed a lot of what they've been practicing. The Vi from the Odd One is something he's going to be picking a lot of throughout.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, they did get their picks in that one, and we know when TSM is comfortable in these situations, they usually do pretty well.
And actually, that was probably one of the first jungle Vi's that I've seen that have been massively successful, because generally, when you use that Assault and Battery, sometimes it can be like the twisted events of Maokai. Yeah. You can be like, oh, I hit the wrong target, going in too deep.
Well, one thing I'll say is everyone has been practicing Vi leading up to these World Championships. We're going to be seeing a lot of her. She synergizes so well with the assassins that we've been seeing in the mid lane lately, just locking down that single target. We're going to see some more successful Vi's.
So we're going to take a quick break, ladies and gentlemen, but when we return, it is going to be the second game of the group stage. It is going to be Korea's SKT T1 and their brilliant mid laner Faker versus Europe's Lemadogs. Plus, OMG's Gogon will be joining us to talk about the fight for the Summoner's Cup. He's going to be joining Joe Miller.